Hi everyone, this is round one. We are on the draw. This one looks like a keep. We have a one drop. Day is not that great on the draw, but still does its things. And here we're gonna lead with Tropical Island into the Atar Shaman so that we don't have any. You know, sometimes it's always good to lead with non-fetchland when you have to play the death rite, because maybe your opponent thinks that you don't have a fetchland and, you know, maybe doesn't kill your death rite in time. Or also prevents your opponent from casting fetchland, so maybe, you know, can make him change a play. So in the future, when you have like a situation like this, it's always better to held to lead with the normal duo, and also we have the brainstorm, you know, to make the fetch lands better. And with the brainstorm, end of turn, and then decay on the effects. Okay, can't do anything about this. And now we're gonna play. We can play Misty Rainforest into Tundra and play Sima Library, and then. But then we can't fetch the blue source, the black source, and don't have a, and have a double white. So we are gonna. So right now I wanna have double white and black. Okay, so I have to go Misty Rainforest. No, it's impossible. Not in my mana base. We don't have Scrubland, so we can't do that. I guess we just give up on having. Black mana, since we don't have any black cards right now. So yeah, let's just play Tundra into Sima Library, and then we go get Underground Sea. Blue is by far the colors that we need the most. Okay, so the library resolves, and now he can only deal with that with the number of decay. Wasteland, I don't mind because we have plenty of, I mean, not that plenty, but I have land here. Alright, I'm to turret, let's see what he gets. He hit Daze and a Jace. Not that bad. Getting rid of the Tundra. Okay. Hero Library, I'm definitely not gonna get the Butter School, and maybe I don't even need the Bayou. Though here I think I wanna get card advantage with the library, which means that in case if my opponent draws a number of decay, I wanna I get card advantage from it. So here I can either brainstorm away the Butter School, sorry, fetch land away the Butter School, and then play brainstorm. Or I can brainstorm now. I know the Butter School is bad, and I think that's what I'm gonna do, because I want to get rid of like a land here. This is very bad here. I've only, maybe I can keep the Butter School at this point. I have plenty of lands. I can maybe get rid of the Umezawajita and the Bayou. Yeah, that's two. Or maybe the fetch land. Yeah, we just save a point of damage. Maybe in later the game we can need the Bayou. So we do like this. We tutor for a Tundra and we pass the turn. This is not that ideal because of course we have it's gonna go after my Tundra again. We actually run out of Tundra. We have only one Savannah as a producing white source, think, which is not that great, but it's okay. So Jace brings Prodigy, and we managed to draw a source of Plowshares, which means that I have to get that land. So here, if I want to have the blue pitch, I have to get to take 8 points of damage, which I think I'm gonna do that. I like to have a force up. So now I'm gonna get the Savannah, which is my last white source. So hopefully my opponent doesn't have an Into Turek. So click this and pass. I Maybe instead of the tundra, when I fetched it before, I should have taken the savanna. So Baleful Streaks, I think I don't mind. Oh, we are five though. Yeah, now let's just let this resolve. I'm fine with this. I'm fine with this. I'd rather counter something like that for a shaman. Oh, Gurmagangler. Yeah, definitely countering that. Now I'm looking for like Deathfire Shaman here. Put this on top. Cast Brainstorm. And put this on top, I guess. When it hit me down to 4 here. Is this another Imp Tuturuk? Sure. I'm gonna let it resolve. Force of Will and drop. Okay. Then what? Another Baleful Strix. Okay, here I can easily die to these Strixes. This is interesting. So put on top and put on top. I need to find source of plowshares, because now I'm gonna go down to 2, and the turn after I'm gonna die. So I need to find a source of plowshares here. Or, yeah. I need to brainstorm now. I didn't. Can fetch though. I'm gonna put back the wasteland and the sword Then I'm going to fetch down to but if I fetch there's no way I can survive with the swords. It can hit something like Humezawa's Jitte to equip the Noble Hierarch. Yeah, that's unfortunate that I shuffled back that Jitte. Could have kept that. What else? What else out I have here? I'd rather not fetch there and just hope to find a source of plowshares with the library as a third card. It's kind of more out than just playing, than just fetching and then hope to draw Umezawa's Jitte, and also hope my opponent, doesn't interact with me. So yeah, let's do that. Let's go with oh, on the other end. Oh no, yeah, nothing. Yeah, see here, the Deathfire Shaman would be way better than Noble Hierarch. Way better. Because we would have been able to just gain 2 life there. So yeah, let's go with the Noble Hierarch. And just pass. I guess that source of pleasure is not that big of an out. Yeah, okay, we're definitely dead now. We're playing against some weird Sultai deck. Jinx, Prince, Prodigy, many weird stuff. Maybe we lost the game when we drew too many cards with a Sylvan Library. But yeah. Yep. Let's concede the game. Alright, let's see how we can sideboard against this Sultai deck. What do we have? We're on the play, so I kinda like these. With my board in no. I guess I guess we don't have that many things. Abu TK deals with Tarmogoyf. which is not a card that we're really, really frightened because we have the swords. So yeah, I kind of like everything in here. Maybe Umezawa's Jita is the worst, but he showed me, you know, plenty of X1s, so maybe that's still a good card. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the old no sideboard for game 2. On the play for game 2, and this looks like a keep. I lead with Flawless Strength so my opponent can't wasteland me, and in case I will tutor for Tundra if I have to play the Spell Pierce, which is very unlikely. Since like there is no basically one drop, I guess Totsies and Ponder are the only one that I can get with that. So let's just go with the Flawless Strength and say go. Okay. Creeping Tar Pit there, which I think I'm gonna wasteland. That means that no, maybe not. Maybe not. I'm gonna just play another fetch land, I think, so that I can spell Pierce what's the name? Heim to Turek, and then just play a 3-drop. A second Creeping Tar Pit. Here I can either fetch land and then shuffle the card that I... Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that just because I'm gonna play a 3-drop next turn, so I'm gonna crack both of my fetch lands. So let's go with... I guess since we don't have any black cards right now, you know, just Deathrite Shaman in the deck, I can just tutor Tundra and Savannah so that I am wasteland proof. So lead with a Brainstorm here. Just Spell Pierce. Don't Spell Pierce back. I don't think I want. Let's just say okay here. Sure, Spell Pierce. Alright, I have the black mana here. So I'm just taking Savannah, play a drop, and playing. So if I play Knight, then you can just decay that. If I play Nemesis, it can wasteland. Sorry, Liliana me. I think I'm gonna play Nemesis here, since it's very unlikely that. So Knight has a you know better upside in case he doesn't have any removal spell. But I have this spell Pierce that maybe he can you know protect the Knight later when I cast it with more mana up. So let's just play Nemesis now. And say go. Hoping my opponent doesn't have a Liliana, in fact. Alright, Brainstorm means that he cannot have Liliana this turn. And then he's... yeah, even the Heim to Turek now, it's fine. I mean, Dream Nemesis can be dealt with Golgari Charm, Toxic Deluge. Not the main thing. Now we also have 4. Alright, Ponder. Sorry, but Magical Land was very quick here. Ponder chose to shuffle. So you went fetch land, Ponder, and then shuffled. Sure. And here I'm going to wasteland him. So I'm going to wasteland his... I think I'm going to wasteland his green source. You know, Tropical Island is... great, of course, because in the mainland, you know, he might be able to not have just an additional land. So when the people shuffles with Ponder, in my opinion, it's just that they have either too many lands or too few lands. In this case, like any other land, let's say. And so, you know, it's just a gamble here. I mean, my read is that it doesn't have any lands, any more lands. So I'm gonna go after, you know, the green mana, and now deploying the Knight of the Reliquary. And in case he doesn't have any more lands, with these 2 blue-black land, he can't deal with that. In fact, he has another land, so that's not the case. That's Bio Decay. Yeah, sure. Okay. Alright, Stoneforge Mystic is an excellent draw. I'm gonna keep attacking him, and then I'm going to take. So we can either take like Battle School or another artifact. You know, Battle School is great because it doesn't go under Abru Decay, but the other artifact is great because we have True Name Nemesis. You know, and we can just equip a sword to the True Name, and that's gonna be great. I think though I want to go with the Battle School. Even if he kills my Stoneforge, you know, I can play that with basically any land, and it forces my opponent to kill the Stoneforge. You kinda always want to have the Battle School to for the Battle School there. This figure that I think I'm gonna spell Pierce. Okay, let's just pierce this. And in case my opponent plays any creature that I want to sort, I think I will just sort in my turn, because this Misty is here as an insurance. In case my opponent wasteland me any land, this is going to replace that. Or in case my opponent, or in case I draw that Thresh Shaman, this is going to get an Underground Sea. Okay, so yeah, double this figure to deal with my Mystic, which means that now I will, okay, I drew the fifth land, which is great. Looking for three. Taking, yeah, Underground Sea, seems to be the best. And then bam, let's play Battle School. And then there's the famous combo of Battle School plus True Name Nemesis, which is kind of unbeatable. Snapcaster Mage into, I guess, Ponder. Yep. Opponent is not the favorite to win this game. Just to shuffle again. Okay, hit the land though. And cast the Deathrite Shaman. We drew Daze, which is obviously very bad. Now, so if we attack with a Germ, it's just going to block with a Baleful Strix. If we equip the True Name Nemesis, we're going to die to Liliana of the Veil. A good play here would be to just attack with the Nemesis and then pass. Put him down to 5. We're going to Sorcerer Plusher the Death Rite, and then we are going to, you know, survive to Liliana of the Veil. On the other hand, we can also Swords to Plowshare the Baleful Strix and attack with both. In this way, he can't kill our Germ, and we're gonna get the 5 damage through. So I think that's the better line. I'm just going to play that, and attack for 7 is going to chump block the Germ with the Snapcaster, very likely, and going down to 6. Next turn, though, he can gain 2 life with a Death Rite and surviving. So maybe the other play would have been better, to just attack with the Nemesis down to 5 and then equip the Battle School onto the Nemesis and kill him. Yeah. This way we give him more out to find a Toxic Deluge. So not sure this was the best play. But, you know, we are still in the driver's seat here. Even if we are very far, like, he has many, many cards in his hand. I think he has 3? Yeah, 3 or 4. 3. Ah, I found that. Okay. Yeah. If we would have a keeper, we could have played around the Golgari Charm. But not playing around Liliana. Alright, we drew Nemesis to replace that, which is obviously a great draw. I'm gonna play that with, yeah, I guess this mana left, we don't really care. True Name Nemesis is gonna gain 2 life, going up to 3. Or does he have a counter spell of any kind? No, he took there for an Underground Sea. Maybe he just ran out of green sources, which is quite strange. Oh, Brainstorm, sure. Exiling land for mana? Then what? Is this a decay? Okay. I don't know why I did that after combat. I may be found with a brainstorm, but. Oh, sure. Let's just pass here, and this is lethal. Since it's at 3 life with a death rate, life gain. Snapcaster Mage, yes, into Golgari Charm. So, not lethal anymore, unfortunately. And, yep. Here we can cast the Daze to not let my opponent using the death rate. But I think it's a very bad use of cards. So I'm just gonna let him gain 2 life or whatever. And yeah, passing the turn here. Kind of fell off here. He's exiling my Nemesis to gain 2 life. And yeah, this game is quite good. I'm enjoying it. End of turn, I'm gonna bounce back the. So he shuffled once again with a ponder. Alright, Chase Rune's Prodigy. Sure. I need to find either an answer for that or, you know, a powerful card. So here, bouncing back the Butterskull. Swords. Okay, that's great. Yeah, let's just cast these. Definitely can make me time out. I only have 9 minutes left, but that's okay. You know, sometimes when you record, it's fine to lose for time. I'm kind of teaching you something, so it's worth the time, I guess. Worth the loss. So here, Jace is flipped. I don't know why it stopped, but it's. I know, it is activated. Yeah. Sorry, my magic line lagged. It discarded Misty Rune Forest, which is obviously the right choice. Flashback in Ponder. Okay, so that one's making a lot of work. I don't know why this deck plays only two or three. Sorry, three. Yeah, but suddenly split two. I think it's a, like a four of it. It's like better than the Noble Ark most of the time, also because it just counter your opponent death rate. Going after my Tundra, sure. And then what? What else? Life from the Loam for 3 lands. Okay. Four cards in his. Oh, is attacking? Oh, decay. That's very unfortunate. Okay. Just cast his brainstorm. Alright. My opponent cannot flashback now with Jace, so this is the right time to just. Okay, so what are we gonna do? We're gonna probably shuffle back this Tundra. I know that we're gonna need land eventually because it's gonna just killing our land. But I guess having swords in our hand, it's probably better. Probably. Not exactly sure, but yeah. And here I'm going to either cast the Stoneforge and cast the swords. Or maybe cast Jitte, since he knows. Alright, here, maybe I want to keep the Tundra in my deck. In case. Yeah. No. No, I'm gonna fetch for so that if I draw a white card right now, right next turn, I can play that. I'm going to play swords just for, you know, mana efficiency. Tutoring for Gite. And play Swords. Next turn, I can bounce the Butter School and then relay it with Chase. He chose to dredge the Loam. Or I can either equip Butter School to Stoneforge. I have 6, so exactly know what happened. I think it just -2 Jace here. Alright, we drew this, which is not ideal. Like, I can also... if I kept the land, no, I can swords the Stoneforge. I can put swords on the swords on the Stoneforge and then attack him so that he kind of. I know it's bad because it's a one. So yeah, let's just put. I guess putting Butter School on the Mystic isn't ideal because again, he's just going to flashback with Abrupt Decay. So -3 Jace to Abrupt Decay. So I'd rather just bouncing back the Butter School and replay it. Also having, you know, Force of Will up. And I have to play fast because we are 1-0, so I guess I'm not able to win this game anymore. Maybe. I'm just going to kind of win this game. But we try. You know, I want to give you the best content possible. Of course, Wasteland. Gonna bounce this. Bay 3. Should have clearly killed a white source, but it's okay. So killed my underground sea. Because if you killed my white source, now I would have been forced to put this back, but yeah, he had the Imp Tutorak, so it's the same. I'm forced now to do this, and he can flashback the decay. Onto the germ. And I can keep this here. Wow, that's a good game. So my opponent has a couple of lands. Unfortunately, I'm very low on time, so I can't know if all he has are lands, which I think it's what he does. Okay, he killed my swords here. Interesting. I drew a wasteland. I'm going to pay. And I don't think I want to kill any lands here. I'm just going to attack with a German pass. I don't want to kill any lands because you know, my opponent is wastelanding me. I need 5 mana to equip the Butter School. So I'd rather just... leave one up. He also has plenty of land in there. Wasteland here is just a colorless land. Killing my savannah, so I'm off out of white source here. Another Jace, sure. If I equip the... Okay. So I can equip the Stoneforge. And threaten him lethal. He has to chump block with the death rite. But then, if he decay the Mystic, I don't have a germ anymore. I mean, I can bounce it back. It's gonna wasteland me. Wow, this is. Yeah, I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to attack. He's going to take 4 and gain 2 life. And then I'm going to play land so that my opponent is forced to flip chase and decay the germ, I think. Maybe. I'm not even sure. Okay, it's just passing here. Oh yeah, he can just block and flip. Yeah, definitely. Draw another wasteland. Okay, let's just keep attacking here. He's going, as I said, to block with Jace and flip. Like, transform it, sorry. then I keep playing my wastelands. Opponent doesn't know that we don't have any more white source in our deck. This definitely gain him so many life if we only we sort this instead of the Baleful Streak like 20 turns ago, as it was one of my choices. But it's okay. Let's see what happened now. Factor Fiction. Sure. So this is not Epiphany of the Drone Yard. So we have two piles here. I guess we don't want Murderous Cat. So we do something like these. But putting this in the graveyard is the same as because it's Jace. This was a cool game. I think you're going to lose because either we don't have any lands and we don't have any like threats because our equipment are basically gone now. He took the death right, chase, and the land. Minus two there. Let's see if I can draw a True Name Nemesis. Nope, just a daze. And yeah, let's attack him. Keep gaining life, sure. Up to 5, and then down to 3. Okay. Yeah, the fourth wasteland. I don't think I have any other target for the Windswept Heath that gives blue mana. That's just a Bayou. So, like, if I draw... even if I draw... I think I can concede at this point. Like, this was a game 2, so I have no clue on winning game 3. And, no interest, let's say. And we're eventually going to lose to his, like, card advantage, I guess. No. Yeah, let's bounce back this. This bar is cool. Noble Arc. Alright, let's concede. This was an interesting game. We end up losing, and I think that there was some line of play that could maybe win the game earlier with the True Name Nemesis. Either equipping it to prevent Golgari Charm, or just sorts of plowshare in these and attack with just the Nemesis. We end up losing to this Deathrite Shaman that gained him like 20 damage, 20 life, or maybe 10 or somewhat like that. Alright, so we'll be back for a second match. We'll be right back.